Hi everyone, this is going to be our dilutions worksheet video explain session. For this worksheet, I want you to be aware of a couple of things. The first thing being that these first three problems are molarity review. They do not have anything to do with this M1 V1 equals M2 V2 formula. This is just review for finding molarity. So if you don't know how to do that, I would refer to my previous video for that information. So moving on down here, I'm going to recopy our M1 V1 equals M2 V2. For dilution calculations, you are going to be given somehow, some way, three pieces of information, and you're going to be missing one. Because what dilutions are used for is figuring out usually how many grams of solute to add to how many liters of solution or vice versa or something like that. So let's read problem number four. It says you need to make 300 milliliters of a 0.4 molarity solution of sodium chloride. So this is what you need. You have a 1 molar solution of sodium chloride. Determine how to make the needed dilution. So what you have is going to be that side. What you need is going to be that side. So right now we're missing one of the halves. We don't know how many milliliters of this we're going to need to dilute to that effectively. Because what we have right here is a volume and a molarity. We have a second molarity, but we don't have a second volume. So once again, we're using this formula for M1, V1. Again, that's the halve side. We only have one of those. We have 1.0 as our M1. We don't have a V1, but we have both M2 and V2. 0.4 is our M2, and our V2 should always be in liters, so we're going to convert this to liters. There. So right now, we can solve for our variable, or this one, this is our variable, by just doing some simple algebra. So we can rewrite this as V1 equals the product of these two, which 0.4 times 0.3 is going to be 0.12. And remember, that's in liters because we put this number in liters. So what this is telling you is that I need 0.12 liters of my 1 molar solution to dilute that to 0.3 liters of my 0.4 molar solution. Okay, let's try this again. Let's try number five. Once again, M1 V1 equals M2 V2. So this one says you have to make 500 milliliters of a 0.5 molar BaCl2 solution, okay? So again, we need this. Immediately after identifying that you need that, you can fill in half of your equation. We need 0.5 molarity. We need 500 milliliters or 0.5 liters of that molarity. What we have is a 2 molar solution. So once again, we have M1. But I don't know how much of this solution I can use to make that one. So that's why V1 is our variable. So we can rewrite this. Once again, we can say 2 V1 equals 0.5 times 0.5. otherwise known as 0.25. Then we divide both sides by 2 to get V1. So, once again, I've identified that I need 0.125 liters of my 2 molar solution to dilute it to this over here. So this is another one of those plug and chug equation situations where all you need to do is identify what numbers go where, and then you are all set to go. Most of these problems are going to be very straightforward, but I wanted to skip ahead a little bit and I wanted to draw your attention to 2 that I know will confuse you if you're just used to the dilution questions. 21 asks you, what is the molarity of a 500 milliliter solution containing 249 grams of Ki? I know some of you will get distracted and you'll try to apply this to M1, V1 equals M2, V2. It's not that question. This is a plain molarity question. Do not overcomplicate it. Quite literally, just convert these 249 grams to moles and then divide by 0.5 liters and you'll have your molarity. Question number 22, on the other hand, asks you how many grams of CaCl2 would be required to produce a 3.5 molar solution with a volume of 2 liters. Okay? So, once again, what this means is that there's 3.5 moles in every 1 liter. So, whenever you see this, that's moles per liter. Okay, so do this one carefully, because again, it's not just a straight M1, V1, M2, V2. All right, just read it carefully. Take in all the information that you've gotten so far about how to calculate molarity and everything like that, and use that to solve the problem. The challenge question, I'm going to leave up to you. I urge you to think about it. Think about the calculations that you're doing. Think about what a solution is. Think about how molarity relates to solutions before you try to solve it. You have to think about it if you're going to do it right. Not every calculation in chemistry is inherently like following the exact same pattern. But as you do them, you'll figure out what you need to do to get the correct answer. If you have questions, please, again, feel free to come to me, contact me, ask me an ELT how to do it. I'm happy to show you. Okay?